Hello, this is Hans from Book Publisher Tools, and I'm ready to show you the new Masks add-on for Mazes 2D Squares. This is part of the 2022 update of the Puzzle Maker Pro Mazes modules. The Masks add-on for Mazes 2D Squares will work for squares, oblique, other shapes and 2D tiles. It will not work for 3D or geometric mazes. To use the mask options, go to the Masks tab on the Puzzle Settings tab. Here you can see several options. You'll need to click Use Mask to let the software know that you want to enable the add-on. You can use the Quick Mask to get a result quickly, or use the Mask Editor to import an image and edit each pixel individually. To use the Quick Mask, click the Use Quick Mask option, then drag and drop a silhouette image onto the white panel. Or you can click the panel and select one on your computer. Now I can click Next Preview, and here you can see the scanned image. It doesn't really look like a dog because it was limited by only 10 rows, but if I would set this to 25 and click Use Quick Mask again, you can see something looking more like a dog. Each time you click Next Preview, the current mask will be used, and if you select Use Quick Mask, it will generate a new one. Sometimes you just want to have more control over the mask, so you can open the mask editor. And here you have other options, such as you can select which colors are background colors, and the background colors will be removed from the image. You can also select the scan sensitivity. What the software will do is for each square count the number of foreground pixels. And with a higher scan sensitivity, it requires less foreground pixels to make the square part of the mask. So if I click Scan Image, you'll see more squares part of the mask. In this case, it's not an improvement, but if you have thinner lines, it may be it's an option to get a mask from that anyway. Likewise, you can set the scan sensitivity very low. That means that it needs many black pixels to have the square included. And in this case, it's not very pretty as well, but it's something to experiment with if the quality of the mask isn't exactly what you want. Sometimes you'll just need to manually edit the mask. The manual editing task tab shows different options. First of all, you can just click each pixel to include or exclude it. You can also set the range to a row or column, and then you can click and toggle an entire row, or if you set it to copy color, you can copy the color of the clicked cell to the entire row. You can also do that for a range of 3 or 5 cells, but in this case you get a warning: cells are not connected. That means you have 2 separate islands of cells, and you wouldn't be able to create a maze, because if the start point is on this island and the end point is on the other island, there will be no possible path from start to end, because these white cells are not part of the maze. You can click these cells, or the entire row in this case, to include them, and you can see the warning is removed and this is a valid mask, but it's not very pretty. What I'm going to do is just scan the image, then click Use the mask, But before I do that, at the top, there's the preset option. That means you can save your masks as presets to you for further use. It's best to include the size of the grid, so you'll remember that, for example, dog 25 by 31. Preset is saved and I can use the mask and go back to the maze window, and here you can see it has used the mask and I can create several mazes with this mask. I could also use this mask for oblique, octagons, or small circles to get different mazes from this mask.